All right, Ethan Larson gets the scoring going for the Trojans tonight. Trojans lead 2-0. 17 minutes and 30 seconds to play here. Sorry for the delay on the start of this. Trying to run the spotlight. And let me know if anyone's listening at home, have my number, send me a text, please, if we have any technical issues with this tonight. We started having issues with this during the senior versus staff game today, and we're trying to see if it's our internet or something else, maybe just the camera itself. So, jump ball forced by the Trojans. Wolverines will reclaim possession. Good defense by Robidoux. And that's on Teshi Lohr. Nice little pull-up floater there. No good. That was my number 25, Peyton Church. Redmond will push for the Trojans. Robidoux gets it over to Larson. Nozzle. Nothing there. Ball green up top. Looks inside to Larson. Larson hits a little move. No good. Nice rebound by number 44, Nathaniel Peterson. Church has it up top. That's to Haug. Gets it over to Kobe Snyder, who drives in. His floater, no good. Rebound goes to Zach Bredman. He'll look to push. Bredman gets a screen from Larson. Doesn't want to do anything with it. Ballgreen has it. He'll pull up from the top of the key. That one's no good. Offensive board goes to Ethan Larson. His putback is also no good. Rebound by Lyric Haug. Teshi Lohr looking to get a screen from Peterson. Baseline, nothing there. Cut off by Ballgreen. Church has it. Corner to Lohr. He'll let a three go. His three's good. Ballgreen had his hand down, and Lohr made him pay. Here comes the head tap by Zachary Bredman. Looking for a high pick and roll here with another screen coming from Ballgreen. Lots of contact. Play through it. Ballgreen into Larson. Nice block. Larson gets it again. Kicks it corner to Nozzle. Far wing to Ballgreen. Looking inside. Now kicks it to Robidoux. He likes that spot. No good. Ball deflected out of bounds by number 44, Nathaniel Peterson. Wadena leads 3-2, 15-23 to play here, first half. Ballgreen, far wing, his three's up, his three's no good. Hustle for the board. Teshi Lohr has it, he's going to look to run. His floater's up, no good. Maybe blocked by Robidoux and then recovered by Robidoux. Ballgreen, excuse me, Bredman, nice crossover. And his layup's good. Bredman has lots of energy. Coached the seniors in the senior versus staff game today and didn't have to play, so he's ready to roll. Nice drive by Peterson, little footwork. Jumper's good, and he's fouled. Looks like that'll be on number four. Nick Robidoux, his first. Excuse me, that was Church, not Peterson, my bad. That was Peyton Church. Nice play by him going to the line for the good old-fashioned three-point play. Free throw's good. Robidoux's first, Trojans first. Wadena leads 6-4, 14-50 to play, first half. Ballgreen, far wing, sides against it, gets it to Bredman. Those two are excellent ball handlers. Larson, he'll let one fly. That one's in and out. Short, excuse me. Rebound went to Haug, who gets it to Lohr. Lohr setting up the offense, gets it back to Haug, back to Lohr. That was to Church. Lohr has it. Drives middle. Nice pass. Floater's good. Kobe Snyder, his first basket of the night. Wadena leads 8-4. Ballgreen skips it across to Bredman. Bredman's going to drive middle. Nice finish by Zach. Zach's leading the Trojans with four. 8-6, 13:56 to play, first half. Inside to Peterson, just a little too much there from Snyder. Trojans take over. Nice play by, looks like, Shane Siegler over there, showing off his athleticism. I guess that's why he's an athletic trainer. Bredman will bring it up. Defended by Snyder. Gets it across to Ballgreen. Screen from Bredman. Ballgreen with a dish to Larson, who finishes and ties the game at 8. Assist Ballgreen. Larson with 4. Lower will bring it up. Defended by Ballgreen. Church. His three's good. Peyton Church came to play tonight. Redmond drives. Nozzle. Baseline cut off to Ballgreen. Decided against it. Went after it again. His three's no good. Snyder will bring it up, gets it up to Lohr. Up top to Church, who's had the hot hand, drives, fights through the contact, wants the fall, but doesn't get it. Up top, swing it to Ballgreen, who's going to drive. Nice finish by Gannon. No help side defense for the Wolverines. WDC leads 11-10, 12:42 to play, first half. Snyder looking inside, nothing there. Gets it to Haug. Nice little dribble by him over to Teshi. Up top to Haug. Gets it over to Snyder. Looking for a screen for Peterson. Churchill drive. Bumped on the way. On the ground. See who it's on. Then number four, Nick Robidoux. His second. Team second. Substitutions for the Trojans. Isaiah Zajac, and number 10, Jack Redmond. Church has it near corner. Gets it to Haug, he'll drive, pull up, short, but it goes in. Takes a nice friendly bounce off the rim. Nozzle up top to Redmond. Little handoff to Zach Redmond. Kicks a corner to Nozzle. He'll drive, nothing there. Hand off to Ballgreen, kicks it to Zajac. Beautiful play for the Trojans. 13-12, Wadena leads, 11:53 to play, first half. Teshi Lohr has it, defended by Ballgreen. He drives in, cut off. Nice back cut by Church. Stolen away by Bredman. Nice block by Nozzle, but right place, right time for number 44, Nathaniel Peterson. Wolverines lead 15-12. Good back cut by Bredman. Nozzle has it. Up top to Jack. Sides against it. He'll drive. Kicks it to Zajac. Couldn't finish. Fight for the board. Goes to Peterson. Good pass by Jack Bredman. Zajac just couldn't finish that one. Church has it. Defended by Bredman. Looks inside. Nothing there. Gets it up top to Lohr. Over to Snyder. Haug has it up top to Teshi. It's defended by Ballgreen. Good ball movement by the Wolverines. That three is good, but number three, Kobe Snyder. His fifth point of the night. Wadena opens their lead to six, 18-12. Ballgreen looking to get a screen, double screen. Gives it back to Bredman, looks inside, skips it across to Nozzle. Nozzle's three is in and out. Fight for the board. Goes to Peterson. Good rebound by him. Teshi gets it. Look, knocks out of bounds. I think it's going to be off of the Trojans. So fumbled the ball a little bit, but recovered and tried to make the pass. So ball will stay with the Wolverines. 30 seconds on the shot clock. Quiggle into the game for the Trojans. And then for the Wolverines, we got number 12, DeAndre Hammond. And number 5, Simon Kreklau. Ball's inbounded to Simon Kreklau, who gets it to Teshi. Drives. Good play by him, but just couldn't finish. Hung in the air long enough to get a shot. Ballgreen drives. Has it knocked out of his hands. And they'll push it up to Teshi. His layup's good. Wolverines with their biggest lead of the night, 20-12. 10:05 to play, first half. Good start by the away team. You know, we talk about the visiting team wanted to get a nice early lead, take the crowd out of it. There is not a lot of energy coming from the crowd right now. Nice job by the Wolverines. Bredman looks to drive. Gets it back past to Ballgreen. Look, stuck in the lane. Somehow comes out of it and makes the layup. Getting awfully close to 3 seconds, but props to Ballgreen for finding a way to finish. 20-14, Wadena leads. Lohr gets it over to Snyder. Snyder's going to look to drive. Back to Lohr. Looking inside for Kreklau, nothing there. Gets it up top. DeAndre Hammond, he'll drive. Gets it to Kreklau. Defended by Zajac. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Church, he'll drive. Good play by Zach Brevin, but no contact. Coach Tumberg's looking for a foul over there, but nothing's called. Ballgreen skips it to Quiggle. Gets it to Jack Brevin, far corner. Drives, Quiggle, spot-up shooter. His three's good. Hit every part of the rim and the backboard. Good touch by Quiggle. I like to call that shooter's touch. Lohr will bring it up. Gets it to Church. DeAndre Hammond has it. Defended by Ballgreen. Excuse me, Bredman. Good defense. Kick it up top. Teshi Lohr, 17 seconds on the shot clock. Looks to break down Ballgreen. Has it knocked away by Bredman, who gets it ahead to Ballgreen. Turnover. There goes Zajac. Odell'd that one. Bredman will set up. It's going to be a quick timeout. 30-second timeout for the Trojans. Thanks, Mr. Brent Halverson. Appreciate the comment. Glad it sounds working through the technical difficulties. So, first timeout of the game by Coach Asgard. Trojans were down 20-12, around a 5-0 run to cut it to 20-17. But got to give props to the Wadena Deer Creek Wolverines, the visiting team. You know, coming up fast, starting hot, and taking that crowd out of it. And that is always the recipe for success when you're the away team. Working on getting a score from our girls' game over in Wahpeton right now. They're playing Edgley Culm. Trying to see if we can get that pulled up on YouTube. So if you're at home and you have multiple screens, the girls' game is currently on the NDSCS YouTube page. So they're live streaming, I believe, probably off their huddle camera as well. So Trojans will inbound. Zach Bredman's going to bring it up. Gets it to Zajac. Back to Bredman. It's going to be a foul on number 5, Simon Kreklau. Bredman will inbound for the Trojans. Gets it to Ballgreen. Comes that screen again from Zajac. Decides against it. Now a screen from Larson for Bredman. Church showing too hard there. Makes contact with Bredman. His first, team second. So both teams have two fouls. Refs are letting them play. Makes it for a good flow. Bredman will inbound again. Gets it to Ballgreen. Trojans trail 20-17. Ballgreen picks up his dribble. Finds Bredman. Fit 13 seconds on the shot clock. Skips it over to Quiggle. Quiggle pull up jumper. That one's good. Teshi Lohr will bring it up for the Wolverines. High post, looking for that back cut. Nice play. Back to Teshi. His three is nothing but the bottom of the net. Nice little play there from the Wadena Deer Creek Wolverines. Extends their lead to 4 after the Trojans had a 7-0 run. They cut it within 1. Bredman looking inside, nothing there. Hits a cutting Larson. Shot fake. And the bank is open for Ethan Larson. Teshi Lohr will bring it up. Slowing the pace a little bit. Gets it over to Church. He's got 6. Lohr has 8. So those are the two leading scorers for the Wolverines. Good looking jumper for number 3, Kobe Snyder. Snyder's 7th point of the night. Ballgreen. He's going to take one from deep. No good. That rebound was by number 5, Simon Kreklau. Snyder will bring it up. Defended by Quiggle. Nice move by him. Kicks it to Teshi Lohr. He's had the hot hand, and he continues. 28-21. Wolverines lead. That's Lohr's 11th point of the night. Bredman defended by Snyder. Looking for Quiggle. Nothing there. Gets it to Ballgreen. Ballgreen looking to get something going offensively. Bredman drives. Nothing there. Kicks it to Quiggle, who's had the hot hand so far, and he continues it. Quiggle. It's 8th point of the night. He's 3 for 3 from the field. Coming off the bench. If you remember, his first three of the game was the one that took right around the rim and off the backboard. That one dropped, and it's just given him confidence since. Lower, he can be defended by Ballgreen. The battle of twos. Comes a screen from Snyder, decides against it. Oh, he did switch, excuse me. Quiggle now on Lower. Larson guarding Church in the corner. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Teshi says, why not? Short. Rebound goes to Zajac. That's that heat check. Ballgreen has it, slowing the pace. Comes that screen, slips it over to Quiggle. Hey, why not? Good looking shot, but just short. Teshi pushes it. Get it up to DeAndre Hammond, but too hot to handle. Turnover, Wolverines. So checking back in the game for the Trojans, number four, Nick Robidoux. Number three, Major Ness. And then we got Nathaniel Peterson coming back in the game, number 44, and then number four, Lyric Haug. Redmond will bring it up. Gets it to Major Ness. Nice pass to Quiggle. Pull-up jumper. Looks good. 28-26. Quiggle's 10th point of the night. 4-for-5 from the field. Lots of contact, and the refs let him play through it. Jump ball. Trojans will take possession with a chance to tie or take the lead with 4:52 to go. Ness inbounds to Bredman. Bredman gets it over to Robidoux. Up top to Quiggle. To Larson. Good ball movement by the Trojans. Larson drives baseline. Kicks it corner. That's Robidoux's spot up. That one's good. Gives the Trojans the lead. Nick and I were talking earlier today. He reminds me a lot of Klay Thompson, but spot up. You can get him the ball in the right spot. Great athletic play by Ethan Larson. Fight for the ball. Goes off of Larson. It's a friendly banter between 44, Nathaniel Peterson, and Ethan Larson. Nozzle back into the game for the Trojans. Trojans lead 29-28. Dribble handoff to Teshi. Hand down, man down, Ethan Larson. Got to get your hands up on the shooters. Redmond will push, gets Larson in the short corner. Has it stolen away by Nathaniel Peterson. As we said earlier, refs are letting him play. Only two fouls called on each side. Not a lot of stoppages here. Church, three's no good. Rebound Ness. I think the Trojan would like to see Major Ness get something going here offensively. Show off his athleticism. Redmond drives, kicks it to Major Ness. Up top to Nozzle. Nozzle's three's no good. Fight for the board. Goes off. Number two, Teshi Lohr. Redmond will inbound. Let's see what they call here. Nope, excuse me. Ness will inbound. Little box set. Gets it up top to Robidoux. Skips it across. Redmond, nice pass. Larson finishes it. Extends that lead to three. Lohr will bring it up for the Wolverines. Snyder looking inside to Teshi. Has it go off his leg. Good defense by Ness. Coach Tonsfeld's happy. By the way, anybody watch that senior versus staff game today? I think Adam Tonsfeld put that to rest that he can still play. If anyone doubted him, that is done. He could put a jersey on right now and be a highly effective player in the Heart of Lakes in Section 8 AA. Nozzle. Kicks it to Bredman. Up top to Robidoux. He's thinking about it. Pull up Jay from Nick Robidoux. Nick must have been lying about the scouting report because he told me he can't shoot off the dribble. Well, there you go. Trojans lead 33-28. Inside to Church. Fighting through that contact. And it's going to be a reach and fall. Bredman getting his hands down. Church will inbound for the Wolverines. See what they run on. A little box set. Peterson, top to Haug. Nice screen down. And he's wide open. Miscommunication by the Trojans. Here comes a timeout by Coach Kevin Tumberg. with that, we're going to thank our sponsors. Thank you to Lee's Electric, Ratzel's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Ball Grain Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnsville Grocery, Barnsville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. So a back-and-forth contest. Wadena taking the early lead. Barnsville just responded. And now Wadena a little run themselves to cut into that five-point lead. So entertaining game. You know, two Section 8AA opponents. Not conference opponents, but Section 8AA opponents. So these playoff section games are important for the playoffs, as we talk about. Glad to hear that the stream looks good. We were having some glitchiness earlier with the senior versus staff game, and then some initial problems too with the JV, but Casey Ellert to the rescue. So it looks good. Hopefully it continues that way. So I do want to forewarn you, if something does happen, I mean, there could be a chance we have to reset it. It might be a slight delay, so just be prepared. Coming up at halftime, we're going to have the third grade bench buddies playing, so you'll see the third grade boys traveling basketball team here from Barnsville. It's great entertainment. They were introduced to the starting lineups. So here we go. Trojans lead 33-30. 2.5 minutes to play before half. See what Coach Asgard drew up. Little handoff to Ballgreen. Nice footwork by him. Has it knocked out. Gets it to his running mate, Bredman, who kicks it to Robidoux. His three no good. Rebound Ballgreen. Finishes it. Trojans lead 35-30. And one thing about Gannon, he is a guard, but for a guard, he's a great rebounder. Robidoux gambles. Church makes him pay. Ballgreen bringing it up for the Trojans. Corner to Nozzle. Back up top to Bredman. Swinging it around. Good ball move by the Trojans. Nozzle likes to shoot. No good. Robidoux has it. Basket's good. Nicholas Clay Robidoux is going to go to line on the and one. Has a chance to finish the three-point play. So Church is second. Wolverines third. Robidoux to the line for one. No good. Fight for the board. It's going to go to Church. Snyder will look to push. Gets it over to Teshi, who's been hot so far. Nice steal by Isaiah Zajac. Tried the wraparound. Beautiful pass by the Trojans. A diagonal boom, the back. Little zigzag play there by the Trojans. Extends that lead to seven. Trojans' biggest lead of the game. Good opportunity for the Trojans to close strong here to half. Maybe get it to double digits. I believe that was Snyder. His three no good. Rebound Zajac. Here comes Ballgreen. Gets it to Bredman. Hesitation, and they're going to get a block. Pretty close call. Maybe beat him, maybe not. And that's why I'm glad I'm not a referee. A couple substitutions here. Grant Quiggle in for the Trojans, number 10, Jack Bredman. And then we got 12, DeAndre Hammond. And 35, Jackson Brown. Ballgreen trying to fight back, nothing there. Up top to Jack Bredman. Gets it to his cousin, Zach Bredman. Zach tried to split the D. Trouble in the corner. Gets it to Ballgreen. Quiggle. 22 seconds on the shot clock. Back to Zach. Zach likes that pull-up J. No good. Rebound Quiggle. Athletic finish by him. Extends the lead to 9. 46 seconds to play. If Wadena goes fast, they can go for 2-for-1. If not, Barnsville will maybe get the last shot. Snyder up top to Haug. Over to DeAndre Hammond. He'll drive. Spin move. Brown. And that's a reach-in foul, so that'll reset. To 20 seconds. So, Trojans will get last shot more than likely. Up top to Haug. Nice D by Quiggle. Teshi's had the hot hand. Good deflection by Quiggle. Shot clock is off. 20 seconds to play. Trojans lead 41-32. See what they call out. 13 seconds, 12, 10, 8. Ballgreen slips. Quiggle's going to hustle. Nice finish by number 3, Kobe Snyder. He's going to cut that 9-point lead to 7. So good finish there for the Wolverines. So at the half, Trojans lead 41-34. Leading the way for the Wolverines will be Teshi Lohr with 11, Kobe Snyder with 9, and Peyton Church with 8. For the Trojans, Grant Quiggle with the hot hand because he came off that bench. And it's barely missed. And he's got 12 points at half. Redmond with 4, Ballgreen with 6, and we know Rabideau's got 7. So some balanced scoring there for the Trojans and for the Wolverines. So we're going to set this down. Hope you guys enjoy some third grade traveling team basketball. Some future Trojans.
Split the pot if you have your ticket, pull it out. Split the pot tonight is worth $108. The numbers are 1-0-8-1-3-2-4-1. 1-0-8-1-3-2-4-1. If you have a winning ticket, please come to the scores table. buddies.
You guys could hear the voice of the Trojans tonight, Mr. Brett Ennegar, talking about Giving Hearts Day. Next Tuesday, our game against Pelican Rapids, the girls' game, that'll be our Giving Hearts Day game here. There will be a silent auction outside in the Commons for Giving Hearts Day to support those projects. And then obviously February 8th is the actual Giving Hearts Day. But just so you know, we'll be doing silent auction here. Everybody will be wearing red. It'll be a very cool night here in Barnesville. So some Section 8AA standings. I normally go over this pregame, but coming in a little busy here. So Wadena, you know, if playoffs started today, they would actually be the 5 seed in Section 8AA. They came in with a record of 2-2 in the section, overall record of 12-4. You know, on the season, they're averaging 70.8 points per game while giving up 57. And if you look at it, they're actually on pace just a shade under their average per game, but on pace to give up a lot more than they normally do. Barnesville averages 66 points per game in the year. We're giving up 63, so right around that. Barnesville's got a record of 7-1 against the section and 14-4 overall. So Barnesville's QRF is 78.2, while Dina's is 63.5. So, you know, this is a big game because if playoffs started today, Barnes would be the 3 seed, Wadena's the 5, so not much separates them. This head-to-head win could be the thing that truly does when you compare the resumes. Barnesville looking to extend their 8-game winning streak. Wadena looking to continue their 1-game winning streak that they're on. It'll be Wadena's ball to start the half, trailing 41-34. We'll see what Coach Tumberg came up with at half. And I'm sure it's going to be a lot of this guy right here, Teshi Lohr, with 11 points, first half points. Back up top to Lohr. There's that 2-3 zone by the Trojans. Rebound goes to Ballgreen. So a different look there by Barnesville. Something I know they work on a lot. It's our Syracuse zone. Mr. John Hodge, I know you'd appreciate that. Big Syracuse fan. Nice steal. That's going to go to Church, who tries to get it to Peterson. Miscommunication. Incidental contact. Robin, who gets it ahead to Ballgreen, who has it blocked and then gets it back and finishes it. Probably made that harder than it needed to be, but they got the 2 points nonetheless. Trojans lead 43-34, 17-10 to play first half. Lohr gets it up top. That's to Haug. Over to Snyder. Back to Teshi. Up top to Church, looking to get going again in the second half. Lohr guarded by Robidoux, who has 2 falls, needs to be smart. Pull up Jays. Good. Bank is open. Ballgreen will look to push. Comes a screen, decides against the screen. Skips it over. Nozzle. 3's no good. Larson tried to bat it out, but Wolverines come away. Lohr is going to be defended by Ballgreen. Very good individual matchup there. Good give and go. Peterson has it deflected by Larson. And Ballgren comes away with it. He wants to push. He's got Robidoux trailing. Gets it to Larson. Back to Brebin over there. Brebin coming off the screen. Good show by Church. Nozzle. Gets it to Ballgren. He wants to get going from the three. His three is short. Thought Laura might try to push there. Trojans lead 43-36. 2 minutes into this second half. Get it to Haug. His three is up. Nothing but net for Lyric Haug. Cuts that lead to four. Dribble handoff to Robidoux. His pull-up jumper is good. Trojans lead 45-39. 15:35 to play, so good answer by the Trojans. Teshi has it and gets it to Haug. Back to Teshi. Up top to Snyder. Looking to break down Nozzle. Over to Church. Good defense by Larson and Robidoux. They're going to get Robidoux for a block. His third, team's first, the second half. 15:20 to play. Trojans lead 45-39. Wadena inbound. Sideline. Teshi Lohr, defended by Ballgren, will set up the play. Snyder, drive middle. Rises up. No good. Rebound for Ballgren. I have no idea how he got that or where he came from, because I thought he was guarding the shooter. Good ball movement by the Trojans. Ballgren decides against the three. Back to Nozzle. Nozzle's three is good. Nozzle's fifth point of the night extends that lead to nine for the Trojans. Quiggle looking like he's going to check into the game. Good D by Ballgren, but looks like Church got his own board there. Over to Teshi. A little too hot from Kobe Snyder. Right idea, good ball movement, but his pass was too high. Quiggle giving instructions to Mr. Zach Redman. Quiggle leading the way for the Trojans with 12 points. Let's see if halftime was his friend or his enemy. Redman to Ballgren. Up top to Larson. Nice back cut by Nozzle. Nothing there. Screen for Quiggle. Pull-up jumper, short. Rebound goes to Snyder, who looks to run. Church is going to pull up a three. That one's good. Good answer by Peyton Church and the Wolverines to cut that 9-point lead to six. 14 minutes to play. Comes that high pick and roll. Brebin fights through the contact. Loses his footing. That's a turnover. Wolverines take possession, trailing by six, 13:54 to play. Church will bring it up. We had some substitutions in for the Wolverines. It's number 35, Jackson Brown. Sets a good screen on Ballgren. Church, back to Teshi Lohr. Try to break down Bredman. Nice spin move. Fights through the contact. And the basket's good. Beautiful finish there by number two, Teshi Lohr. His 15th point of the night, has a chance to go to line to finish the three-point play and cut that lead to three. Free throw's good. Cuts the lead to three. Ballgren, or excuse me, Zajac into the game for the Trojans. Ballgren will bring it up for the Trojans. Tapping his head. Kicks it to Nozzle, mishandles it, gets it back to Ballgren. Looking to hit that spin move, beautiful footwork, and they're going to call him for a travel. Turnover Trojans. Wolverines with a chance to tie it. Well, well, well. Looks like we have a special guest. Mr. Braden Bredman, how are we doing, sir?
We're doing great. How are you?
Good. Good. So, Braden, I know I... Oh, Teshi Lohr to tie it up. And that's going to take a timeout there from Coach Kevin Thunberg. Ties it up, man. That Teshi lower guy, he's got 19 points on the night.
Yeah, he's playing phenomenal.
Phenomenal. Yeah, he's quick.
He's very quick.
Quick, and he can shoot. I mean, it's a tough matchup for anybody. Mm-hmm. So, Braden, what's new in your world?
Oh, not much. Just going through the college life.
College life, sir. So you normally listen. So what brings you? I guess it's the weekend. Is that why you're here?
Oh, yeah. Yep, got to come support the little brother.
Little brother. So what's the story? How did he gain the nickname the Czar?
Oh,
so
God.
Czar Bredman. What? There's got to be something.
You know, me and my other brother, older brother, you know, we always had nicknames for him, but, you know, one wasn't really prominent. And, you know, Zachary came out. I don't even remember what he's doing, but I don't even know. It just kind of clicked. We just said his name and added the R at the end, and that was just
Czar. Yeah, and I mean, so many guys call him that, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think a single person really called him by his full name. Maybe Zach here and there, but no, it's Czar.
Nice rebound by Ballgreen. Gets it up top to Nozzle. He likes that spot. No good. Fight for the board. Somehow Quiggle comes up with it. And hits that tough fadeaway jumper. Gives the Trojans the lead, 50-48. Quiggle's leading the way with 14 for the Trojans. Braden. That three is good. These guys can shoot it.
Great shooting team.
Yeah. Lyric Haug gives the Wolverines a one-point lead. Don't you live in Wadena?
I do.
Yeah.
I do, yeah.
So who are you cheering for? Obviously.
Oh, yeah.
Silly question, right?
Yeah. Silly.
That's going to be a moving screen on Gannon Ballgreen. His first, team's third. So some a sloppy start for Barnesville here in the second half, Braden.
Yeah, pretty sloppy. I mean, I think they weren't really used to this pressure right away. I think they underestimated them, and Wadena came out hot, pulled a couple threes in their face.
Yep.
You know, low fouls in both halves, which I don't think they were expecting.
Yeah, refs are letting them play, that's for sure.
Yeah, and I kind of like to see that a little bit, just to get a little physicality,
yep.
Just to kind of get the teams going at it.
Speaking of that, nice play by number 35, Jackson Brown. He saved it with Zajac standing on the line and threw it off of him. So great athletic play. And you know, sometimes it's not just the physical attributes. It's like your mind. You got to think, what can I do with this? And he made the right play.
Yeah.
Snyder cut off by Bredman. Ballgreen's got to be careful. He's got a mismatch there. Size-wise, Peyton Church, I tell you what, I've been very impressed with him. And the second we talk about them not calling fouls, Braden, here comes two fouls.
There we go.
A short amount of time.
Yeah, Zajac impressed me a lot. Right away, you know, it was kind of slow for him, but he's gotten to the groove of it, and he's just been phenomenal.
Yeah, I agree.
Same with Quiggle.
Quiggle, too. Oh, Church. Nice shot by him. Extends that lead to four. Bredman kicks it across to Ballgreen. Nice screen from Zajac.
Oh.
Right idea, just a better pass. And I would say that momentum obviously is on Wadena's side right now.
100%. Trojans got to figure something out. Keep that momentum from stopping.
Barnes looks like they're going to come out. Well, I thought maybe their matchup, but nope, they're going to stay man-to-man. Shots no good, but guess who? That hustle guy right there, Jackson Brown. Teshi lowers three. No good. Zajac uses his height to get that one. Now your brother's going to want to run. Fadeaway jumper. No good. Fight for the board. And one of those smart plays
great
again.
Great play again.
By Kobe Snyder. Wolverines will take possession. How many times do you think Zach's crossed you up?
Oh, too many to count on my hands.
Some good one-on-one games in the driveway?
Oh, too many.
Too many.
Too many to count.
Who won more?
Oh, he did. Yeah. I'll let him take that.
Good block by Zajac. But Teshi Lohr showing off what he can do. Get into the paint anytime he wants. Jack Bredman for three. No good. Snyder will look to go here. Beautiful behind the back, and he can't throw to Teshi, who's coming across. Church, No good. Rebound Quiggle. Baskets are tough to come by right now. Wadena leads 54-50. 9:55 to play second half. I really think they got to get Ballgreen going here, right?
Yeah, he's been struggling in the past couple games. You know, it's just it's a mental state.
It is.
And that's you just got to come out of it. And
basketball is such a long season, you know what I mean?
It is.
You're going to have your hot streaks, and you're obviously going to have your cold streaks.
Yep.
Shot clock is set to expire. So Ballgreen's shot hit the rim. Should have reset to 20. So we'll see what... This is the new thing in Minnesota, right? So,
thank God I didn't have to deal with that.
Yeah.
Just count the bucket.
I know. This is always the debate, right? What's going to happen here? And the tough part is you know, they did that, and Zach hit that three, right? I mean, killed that play.
Killed that momentum.
But they're doing the right thing because we'll see what it's set at. 17 seconds. So Wadena leads 54-50, 9:31 to go. 15 seconds on the shot clock for the Trojans. Ballgreen gets it to Robidoux, loses it off his foot. Nice play by Snyder. Kicks it to this DeAndre Hammond, up to Church, to Lohr, over to Snyder. Defended by Larson, up top to Lohr, moving the ball around nicely are the Wolverines. Ooh, might have got away with the travel. 18 seconds on the shot clock. Church drives in. Snyder for three.
That one's good. Great shooting by this Wadena team.
Yeah, they came out firing second half. 57-50, 8:50 to play. Robidoux, fadeaway jumper no good. Push in the back there on Teshi. First foul on the Wolverines. That's Teshi's first. 57-50, 8:46 to play.
Redmond in for Bredman,
yeah. That's fun to say. Had that last year probably too. All right, box set, what do you think they're running?
Kick out play, probably.
Ooh, looking inside to Zajac.
Good dish.
A lot of movement there. Yeah, if you're not communicating on the defensive end. Looks like we got Tate. Is that Lokes?
Yep.
And Alexander Nowitz, right?
Yes, sir.
Class of 23, represent. Lokes looks like he could still step on the football field for us.
Oh, God, yeah. He always could.
True. One of those guys that has the genetics that we all wish we had. Robidoux with the steal. He's got pressure from behind, and he's fouled, and we'll go to the line for two. Big play by him.
He's a beast.
He is. He's been shooting the ball well as of late.
He's like, what, 5'8", probably pushing 190?
5'8"? Let's see what our... Robidoux. 6 foot.
There's no way.
You don't believe him, all
nope,
right?
No. Nope.
I guess we can measure him after the game. Trojans with a chance to cut it to three, a one-possession game after trailing 57-50. Robidoux's free throw's no good. Rebound Zajac.
Going up for two more.
And he's followed by Nathaniel Peterson. That'll be Peterson's first. Team's third. So I think the fouls were 4-0 now, and all of a sudden it's starting to even out. But Barnes will be more aggressive, right? Hustling to the board, just trying to attack. So Zajac with a chance to cut it to two. First one short. Eight ten to play. Zajac to the line for one more. Second one is good. 3-point game, 8-10 to play. Are we going to see a little 2-2-1 back into their 2-3 zone? I'm assuming here. We'll see. Looks like they'll trap corner. Nice play.
Great
nice
drive
finish by Nathaniel Peterson. Just aggressive, put his head down, and got to the hole. Sometimes that's the easiest thing to do. And then you get a charge the other times, right?
Yep.
Zach's three, no good. Hustle for the board, goes into Teshi Lohr. Tries to finish. Zajac uses that 6'5" frame. Ballgreen drives in, fights through the contact, and we'll go to the line for two. I think that's going to be on Church. We'll see. His third. team's fourth.
Free throw is a big part of the game.
Absolutely. Missed two of the last four, right?
Yeah. You got to make those. That puts you up, what, 2-3 points really quick.
Yep. That's why they're free, right? Called free throws. Free for a reason. Take your time. Walgreens' first free throw is up and good. Nozzle checking into the game for the Trojans. So interesting. Going a little smaller here, right? Surrounding Larson with the four guards with Robidoux, Zach, Cannon.
Yeah, interesting Nozzle. Matchup. Interesting matchup we got going on out here.
One lineup I'd love to see. I don't know if we'll ever get to it. Is Quiggle in for Larson? A little
three smalls. Well, five smalls.
Well, five smalls. It's like the Warriors, right? They're a death lineup, they'd call it. That they'd run at the end of the game, and they're just so hard to match up with and score points. Snyder has it up top, gets it to Hammond, gets it over to Church. Church has three fouls. Tachilor shot fake. He'll let one fly, and that's good. Good footwork by him. Got Zach in the air. 62-56. That's Lohr's 22nd point. Inside to Larson. Tries to pass to Ballgreen. Deflected out of bounds by the Wolverines. 6-point game, 6:58 to play. Barnes will inbound him. Back pick by Ballgreen. Get it into Ballgreen. He's trying to get going. Rebound goes to Lohr. He'll take his time bringing it up. 6:50 to play, 6-point game. Haug. Ballgreen gambles and loses. Kobe Snyder finishes his 8-point lead for the Wolverines.
Now with the depth of the Wolverines here, their conditioning must be phenomenal.
Yeah, they don't play a lot of guys, you're right. You are right. Robidoux fakes the dribble handoff. Pull-up jumper's no good. Fight for the board. That's won by Lyric Haug. 6:10 to play. Wolverines lead by 8. Haug has it. He's going to let one fly. No good. Rebound goes to Ballgreen. He's going to push. Finishes the layup. And that's going to be a quick timeout by Mr. Matt Askegard. It's going to be a 30-second. I knew he had four left. I was wondering when he's going to start taking them. Good opportunities. They try to cut in this lead. We'll take time here to thank our sponsors of Lee's Electric, Ratso's Pool Hall, Four Hill Farms, Ballgreen Construction, Midwest Bank, Barnesville Grocery, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Dean's Bulk Service, and Together Counseling. So, Braden, what did the Trojans have to do here to cut into that lead? Who's sending pictures of us?
Alex.
Nice. Very nice.
You know, boxing out, that's probably one of the keys. Free throws, you got to make those. And then just being aggressive.
Well, being aggressive, what we've seen on the defensive end is we're gambling, we're shooting gaps. And when we do that, they're making us pay either with pull-up jumpers or three-pointers, right? Because then it helped defense has to step in. So I don't know what the solution is there. But, they've been shooting well, and that's sometimes tough to stop.
Trying to bring a little full-court pressure.
Nice. So they're going to deny Lohr the ball. So we'll see what they do here. And that's Gannon Ballgreen hustling back, almost with a beautiful play.
Sprinting from coast to coast.
Coast to coast, yes. And once again, next Tuesday, there'll be a silent auction for Giving Hearts Day, February 6th. So if you're coming on out to the game, just know there'll be a silent auction. It's going to be a red out for Giving Hearts Day. Robidoux misses the layup.
Maybe a little contact and rest didn't catch.
Nope. We talked about them letting them play. Nice pass by Lohr. Extends that lead to 8, 5.5 minutes to play. Revin will look to push, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Yeah, he was going through him. I know him too well.
Yeah. That was a good play. Beat him to the spot.
Yep.
So Brevin's third, team's fifth. Trojans down 8, 5 minutes and 20 seconds to play. Lohr gets it over to Snyder. Haug has it up top to Church. Nice jab by him. Haug gets it to Teshi. Over to Snyder again. Wolverines are content with working the shot clock. Larson blocks it, but they're going to call him for a foul.
You know, great job by that offense. You know, swinging the ball, getting the defense moving, and finish it with a quick pass down to the post. Now he's shooting two.
He's shooting two. Smart play by them. You know, I mean, they know when they break, they're able to penetrate where that help side defense is coming in, who's going to be open. First free throw is up and good by Nathaniel Peterson. He'll get a second with a chance to extend this lead to 10, which would be the biggest lead of the game, I believe, for either team. No one's no good. Wolverines lead by 9, 4:55 to play. And with this too, you know, possessions are going to be at a premium here as the clock winds down, because you know shot clock, you can,
yeah.
There goes half a minute with that 35. So Teshi Lohr trying to get past Zach Bredman. Over to Church. Snyder up top to Haug. Over to Lohr. Nice spin move by him. Good defense by Zach. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Church is going to look to take Ballgreen. Can't finish. Rebound Larson. Robity's going to look to push here. Trojans need to be in a hurry. Larson, pull up three. That one's good. Cuts it to six.
Got some lucky bounces in there.
Yeah, two possession games. Big possession for the Trojans as a trail by six. And we saw the Wolverines' strategy last possession, right? They're going to take it down to the end of the shot clock. And there's Snyder, though, elevating on that jump shot. It's a good-looking jump shot.
Great rebound by Nick Robidoux.
Ballgreen's going to look, see what he's got. Larson had the hot hand. He'll drive. Lots of contact. Letting him play right now. Haug. Peterson. As we said, is letting him play, and that one can't go down. That would have been a big basket for the Wolverines. Barnes with a chance. Ballgreen, can he get going? No. Trail by six with 3 minutes and 10 seconds to play. Yeah, kick it.
I can't.
No, don't do that.
That wouldn't be good.
Lohr with a dribble handoff to Snyder. Over to Haug. Nice move by him. His shot is blocked. And by the looks of it, I know Ballgreen's pushing that way, so it looked like it went back and then sideways. I don't know. That's a tough one. We argue that it went off of him, but nonetheless, no replay here.
That was questionable, but great defense by the Trojans. Yeah. You know, pushing that baseline. You got that baseline help coming up. Great job.
Look at you talking, coach.
Yeah, I ain't near that.
Church to Haug. Over to Lohr. Snyder. Been shooting the ball well. And Brown, I tell you what, that Jackson Brown making a lot of plays there by just being aggressive. Trojans trail by six, 2:38 to play. Lots of contact there. It's going to be a hand check.
Very physical.
Kobe Snyder second, team's fifth. 2:35 to play, 27 seconds on the shot clock. It's going to be a full timeout by Coach Askegaard.
Number 12, Ethan Larson looking a little tired out there.
Yep, Larson, I think, still getting back into the swing of things. Even though I know we are in February, it's weird to say, and it's 40-something degrees out. I see 50 degrees next week.
Really?
Yeah. It makes you wonder, are we going to be having softball and baseball outside to start the year? That'd be crazy. I don't know if it's been done in my time that I can remember. But I will thank our sponsors again. So thank you to Together Counseling, Dean's Bulk Service, Barnesville Drug and Hardware, Barnesville Grocery, Midwest Bank, Ballgreen Construction, Four Hill Farms, Ratzel's Pool Hall, and Lee's Electric. So snowball week. Braden, do you remember snowball last year?
Terrible. I hated it.
Why?
I don't know. Something about it.
I got pied in the face today.
Yeah, how'd that feel?
I can still smell the ready whip, if that's what it was. I can still, when you walk into the middle gym, that's where we did it. I can still, I don't know. It's tough. I've taken like two showers since that. But
yeah, it'll be with you for a while.
For sure. But that was fun, you know, raised money for the student council.
That's good.
Had that senior versus staff game today. Justice was served.
Nah, I don't think so. Students definitely won that game.
No. Did you see the score?
No.
Staff won. Come on now.
Well, I mean, last year students won. That was
rigged.
It wasn't rigged. I was a ref.
That's why I decided that, you know what, I got refs this year. Matt Samuelson and Travis Hughes came in. Supposed to
see,
have.
That's when you rig it.
No.
You elder people.
I want what's fair. Bredman drives. His floater's good. Big basket. You know what? Smart by the Trojans. They drew up a quick hitter there, right? So it took barely any time off that clock. 4-point game, 2:21 to play. Once again, we'll see the Wolverine strategy. This is correct. They don't need to be in a rush. Don't need to be in a hurry. And this guy can break down anybody. And he's going to be fouled. We'll see who it's on. Larson's third, team seventh. So Teshi lower to the line for two. Big free throws. First one is good. Back in the game for the Wolverines is Nathaniel Peterson. Second free throw coming. That one's good as well.
Huge.
Extends the lead back to six. 2:10 to play.
Need some good shots coming from the Trojans now.
Need a quality possession here because, as we talked about, these possessions are limited. You don't need a three, right? I mean, I think people assume we got to go big here. You don't. You can go for the two.
No, you don't. I mean, you go for the quick, easy points.
Ballgreen was wide open in the lane. Missed him. Larson drives. And, you know, maybe not the possession the Trojans wanted there. But still plenty of time. Trojans don't need to foul. Can apply that full court pressure. Bredman defending Teshi Lohr over there. 24 seconds on the shot clock. They can run this down to about a minute nine if they choose. Drives in, kicks it to Church. And that might be your dagger. It extends the lead to nine. 1:16 to play. Trojans have to go fast. Ballgreen kicks it to Quiggle. Over to Larson. His three's no good. Rebound one by Haug. Lohr will bring it up, and he's going to be fouled by Grant Quiggle with 1 minute to play. And he'll go to the line for a 1-1. So, we know basketball. We know a minute can be like 5 minutes. So, still a lot of game left, but he's got a chance here to extend this to double digits. And as we talked about, they're going to have to be quick shots, and threes are going to have to be involved here.
Yep.
So lower to the line for a 1-1. First one's good. Extends that lead to 10.
Got a feeling Tweaker and number 44 are going to duke it out on this one.
I think they've been, you know, going at it the right way. I don't think it's been anything cheap, right?
No, not cheap. Just, you know,
it's hard.
Hard, yep. Aggressive playing.
Ballgreen's going to drive fast. Layup no good. One by Snyder, and he's going to be fouled by Larson. Ballgreen and Larson upset with themselves. So Snyder to the line for the 1-1. Larson's fourth, as he said. Team's ninth. Free throw no good. Robbie with the board gets it up to Larson. Got to go fast. Nozzle. His three's good. There comes that timeout by Coach Asgard.
You know, Trojans coming out on defense. What do you do? Just full court man-to-man.
And you try to go for the steal, but after a certain amount of time comes off, then obviously you got to play the foul game because, 35 seconds and 40-something seconds left in the game.
Yeah.
But you're right. You gamble. You go for the steal, then obviously maybe you have the scouting report on free throw percentage. I don't know. Probably have a guy, someone in mind that you want to foul.
Yeah. I mean, you gamble. You know that Wadena takes over once they know, they recognize you're gambling, and they get it just right. A little couple points up for Wadena.
Yep. And I'll tell you what, if I was playing, they'd be like, yep, foul Schindler, put him on the line. That's what
I don't even think I'd be out probably there. I think 50, I'd be
60%
right
free throw shooter, so.
I'd be sitting right bent.
So if Wadena is able to win this, you know, they were 12-4. They'd move to 13-4 in the year. Barnesville would drop to 14-5. And you know what? This would be a big section win for Wadena. And it would end Barnesville's 8-game winning streak. So, you know, a lot on the line here. But, once, like I said, pregame or actually halftime, it's just these section wins, you know, they add up, Braden win. They start comparing resumes and start seeding you for playoffs, you know. Robidoux is going to get the foul on Peyton Church. So Church, the line for the double bonus. But for the Trojans there, no time really went off that clock. So
No, not much. Which helps out the Trojans, but, you know, now they got a for sure two shots.
Church to the line for two. First one is good. Church's 18th point of the night. Second one is also good. Extends the lead back to nine. Get it ahead to Bredman. Smart play by Ballgreen leads him over to Ballgreen. His three is no good. Rebound goes to Church. And they're letting him play. And they get a timeout. I think they wanted a jump ball or a travel there, but they give the timeout to Wadena. So Wadena has it. We'll see what it is. Full timeout, leading by nine. Braden, 30, you know, it's...
35 seconds.
35 seconds. So obviously the thing, too, is you have to remember 5 seconds. So you look at the shot clock, it's 30 seconds. So they are in the backcourt right now. They have 5 seconds to get it across because... It's taking them 5 seconds, right, just in that little skirmish for the ball. So do you play 5 seconds? You try to force the 10? Yeah, you probably do. I mean, it's 5 seconds. It's a nine-point game. Maybe get it. Obviously, you're going for the quick steal. Then you need a quick bucket, and it's just the hack-a-shack, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah. That's all you can do, play great defense. Hope you get that 10 seconds.
For something weird to happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe you gamble, you get a quick bucket, and go right back into it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, 32.2 seconds to play, 30 seconds left in the shot clock, 5 seconds left for Wadena to get it across half court. Coach Asgard asking Mr. Rob Nudella a question. One thing we like about Askey, he doesn't yell, he likes to ask questions. Get into the Church. And he's going to be fouled by Ballgreen. So Peyton Church to the line for two. Shot clock is off. So Ballgreen second. Double bonus here for the Wolverines. First one is good. Second one is also good. Extends that lead to 11. Bremen's three. Short. Rebound goes to Teshi Lohr. Gets it up to Snyder. Why not? 79-66. 15 seconds to play. And that looks like it'll do it. You know, when I look back here, Braden, there was that last possession before half. You know, Ballgreen had it. The Trojans were up nine. Had a chance to extend it to double digits, but Ballgreen slipped. And they had that fast break layup to cut it to seven right before half. To me, that was that. And then the start of the second half, right? It was all Wolverines pretty much. So, you know, you look back on that play, not one play. It's just, I feel like momentum in that moment sort of, it shifted, right? But, hey. Wadena's record, like I said, was 12-4. Now they're 13-4. They're a really good team.
Great team.
Barnesville's record, like I said, drops to 14-5. So two teams, maybe they'll meet up again in the playoffs because Section 8 8AA opponents. But Barnesville can't sit on this one too long because they have Frazee tomorrow at 1:30 at Concordia. So an HOL game for them. not a Section 8 AA game because Frazee boys are Section 6A. They dropped down to single A. But what's weird is the Frazee girls are still Section 8 AA. So just a little tidbit for people at home. But tomorrow for Barnesville, I think the important thing is to, you know what? Yeah, it's tough. You lost.
Yeah.
But you got to have that. You got to be able to move on, right?
Yeah, we got to have some tunnel vision. You know,
absolutely. Because you know what?
Game, you learn something and you go on to the next.
For sure. A lot to learn from this, but they got a lot to play for still.
Yep.
They're 7-0 right now in the conference.
Yep.
Tomorrow is the 8th conference game. So tomorrow would be 3/4 of the conference season. If they can go 8-0 through 3/4 of that season, they're putting themselves in good position here, Braden, to do something that hasn't been done in 22 years, and that's win the Heart of Lakes Championship.
Yeah, I mean, that'd be great to see. I mean, Askey, he's put together a good group of kids playing, and I'd like to see it.
Yep, and, you know, they're still competing, too, for the Section 8 AA, one seed, two seed stuff with, you know, all that, because they beat Pelican, so they own the head-to-head to Pelican. But now the tricky thing is Wadena owns the head-to-head over us, so when it comes down to comparing and stuff, that's where it gets tricky, and that's why I don't get paid the big bucks to do the QRF seating. So, but anyway, hey, Braden, I appreciate you coming on. I am going to say you are bad luck because once you came over here, things took a turn for the worse. So
I'm sorry. I'll never do it again.
But, no, thank you. Have a good weekend back home. Obviously, stay safe, and I will look forward to maybe seeing you again down the road.
Yes, sir.
All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, as the sun sets on tonight's game, we'd like to take a moment to acknowledge the hard work and dedication displayed by both teams on the court tonight. Win or lose, it's the spirit of the game and the camaraderie among these young athletes that truly stands out. Thank you all for listening and supporting our students, Barnesville students, as well as Wadena Deer Creek students. Until next time, stay safe. And you know what? Before I end, I just want to give a couple things, shout outs and some good lucks for tomorrow. So tomorrow's a big day here for quite a few activities at Barnesville. We're going to have our one act play competing in the section championship over in Holly. So the section one act play meet is tomorrow in Holly, and they have not competed, or I should say this, they haven't won the subsection. So they took first place in the subsection last Saturday. That hadn't been done since 2014. So something very cool there. Tomorrow, our boys, varsity boys and varsity girls, will be playing at Concordia in a doubleheader. So good luck to the one act. Good luck to basketball teams at Concordia. And then also we have Chase Houck, who is wrestling down at the ninth grade state tournament happening at Champlin Park. So he will wrestle tomorrow morning. I think it's around 8:45 it kicks off. So he took second at the qualifier in Monoman last weekend. He gets a chance to compete for a state championship at the ninth grade state. So once again, good luck to one act play tomorrow. Good luck to the basketball teams. Good luck to Chase Houck. And then good luck to everybody participating in the snowball dance. Be safe and go Trojans.